Sis?
Oh God, Rooster, I never would have known it was you in 100 years.
Fooled you, Aggie, and we're gonna fool Warbucks too.
Get us the 50,000 big ones.
This is gonna be the best bunko job ever, Aggie. I know a guy out of jail who can doctor up a couple fake voice certificates or anything else you might need. But we need your help, sis, for details about Annie that can help us pull this thing off.
Sure, I can help you. A lot. But what's in it for me, Ralph?
Three-way split, Aggie.
Half.
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 Half, half, half. Straight down the middle. 25 grand each. But we gotta do it fast, Aggie. Give him some of the old Rooster. Razzle dazzle. In and out. 2-3 minutes at the most. Get the money, get the kid, and get the hell out of town.
The kid, Annie, that's the problem. What do we do with her afterward?
Aggie, that's no problem.
When Rooster wants something to disappear, it disappears.
For good.
Rooster!
Aw, come on, Aggie. We get the 50 grand, we blow this crummy town, and then Lil and me will meet ya.
Where? Oh, yeah.
It's a dream. Annie is the king.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
It's a dream. It's a dream. That's where we're born.
Roosevelt has so far lived up to none of his lofty campaign promises. All we have had from Franklin Delano Roosevelt and his so-called brain trust.
Brain trust?
Is a great deal of high flow talk and virtually no action. In a nation wracked by poverty, misery, and unemployment, it is deeds we want from the White House, not words. In short, Mr. President, if you are listening, we've had enough of your fireside chats. It is time to...
Criticism, Danny! Nothing but criticism, Danny!
I know.
It's awful!
Has anyone seen the Washington Post this morning?
My friends, I say again, the only thing we have to fear is fear itself.
Franklin, you've already been elected.
Every cloud has a silver lining. You're never fully dressed without a smile.
All for Warbucks and friend, Franklin.
Thank you, Louis. Show them in. Oliver, so good of you. And who is this we have here?
Mr. President, this is my good friend, Annie.
Annie?
She so wanted to meet you that I couldn't resist bringing her along just to say hello.
Of course, the little girl who sang so beautifully on the radio last night.
Annie, this is President Roosevelt.
How do you do, President Roosevelt?
How do you do, Annie? You're as lovely as you sounded on the radio.
Thank you, President Roosevelt.
Well, shall we begin?
Annie, if you wait outside...
No, Oliver. Let Annie stay. Having a child on hand will keep us on our best behaviors.
Thank you, Mr. President. Annie?
And Harold, I don't want to hear even so much as a gosh out of you.
Franklin, a child?
Now, Oliver, since you speak for those happy few Americans who have any money left, I'd like to begin with your views on matters.
Mr. President, in the words of Calvin Coolidge, the business of this country is business. Yes. And for the good of you, the country, Wall Street, and me, we've got to get my factories open and the workers back to work.
According to my latest figures, there are now 15 million Americans out of work and nearly 50 million with no visible means of support.
Mr. President, if I may say so, unemployment is not our worst problem. The dispatches from Germany are getting worse and worse. There could be war!
Germany, hell, people are starving in this country.
Harold, I know that, but in the long run...
Cordell, for people who are starving, there is no long run.
The trouble is, it's all happening at once. The stock market's taking another nosedive.
Sit-down strikes, riots.
Floods, dust storms.
And the FBI still hasn't caught Al Capone. Well, at least we're all agreed on one thing. The situation is hopeless and getting worse.
I'd like to see those figures.
The sun will be out tomorrow. Get your box
up. Quiet, little girl.
Harold, what did you say, Annie? No, go ahead. It's all right, my dear. It's still a free country.
Just thinking about tomorrow, there's a way there comes and the sorrow. Till there's love, when I'm stuck with the day, that's great and lonely. I just stick up my chin.
Bet your bottom dollar that tomorrow there'll be some
Perkins.
Just thinking about tomorrow clears away the cobwebs and the sorrow. Till there's
sorrow for the present, when I'm stuck with a day that's gray and lonely,
until tomorrow. Come what may. Tomorrow, tomorrow, I love ya. Tomorrow, you're always a day away. Tomorrow, tomorrow, I love ya. Tomorrow, you're always a day.
Hundreds of couples standing outside house, all claiming to be Annie's parents.
Oh boy!
Have begun to screen them, suggest that you return to New York immediately. Signed, Grace Farrell.
Well, it looks as though the Hour of Smiles has more good listeners than we thought, right?
Gee, hundreds of couples. One of them is bound to be my mother and father.
Well, Oliver, I suspect you'd better get back to New York immediately.
Yes, Mr. President, if you don't mind. Annie?
Bye, everybody.
Bye, Annie.
Goodbye, Mr. President, and thank you.
No, thank you, Annie. You're just the type of person a president should have around him.
Mr. President, what if we set up 100? No, 1,000 federal projects.
Dams.
Yes.
Highways.
Yes.
New post office.
Yes, and put the unemployed to work building them.
We could create 5 million new jobs within 6 months.
And weekly paychecks put all those millions off relief and back to paying taxes.
We'll build a country so strong that nobody, including Chancellor Hitler, could ever defeat us in a war.
Mr. President, what we've got to give this country is nothing less than a new outlook.
A new vision.
A new approach.
A new concept.
A new spirit.
A new horizon.
A new dedication.
A new attitude.
A new deal. I was right the first time. The only thing we have to fear is fear itself. Tomorrow, tomorrow, I love you. Tomorrow, you're only a day away. Harmony.
Tomorrow, tomorrow, I love you. Tomorrow, you're only a day.
That makes
1,236.
All liars, Drake. I never knew there were so many dishonest people in the island of Manhattan.
Some of them were from the Bronx, miss.
Grace, we're back.
Where are they, Miss Farrell? Where are all the people?
They're gone, dear. Come and gone. None of them were your parents. They were after nothing but the $50,000.
Are you certain?
Yes, none of them knew about the locket. I'm so sorry.
Gee, I thought for sure one of them was going to be my mother and father.
Mr. Willox, special message from the FBI.
Good. Elliot Ness has located the manufacturer of Annie's locket in Utica, New York.
Oh, boy!
Lockets of this type were made between 1918 and 1924.
Wait, type of lockets?
Yes. Over 90,000 were made and sold.
90,000?
According to Ness, the gist of it is that there isn't a chance in a million of finding your locket. We're tracing your parents through that locket. I'm so sorry.
That's okay. I mean, gee, you did the best you could. If you can't find them, nobody can. Anyway, I guess a kid can get along without folks. You didn't turn out so bad. You got everything. All them Duesenbergs hanging on the wall and everything.
Excuse us, sir. We'll go check on the dinner menu.
Annie, a Duesenberg is a car. Babe Ruth is the right fielder for the New York Yankees. And there's something else I think you should know.
I made me a fortune, that fortune made 10. Been headlined in profile again and again. Yet something was missing, I never quite knew that something was someone but who. My speeches are greeted, thunderous acclaim at two universities bearing my name. Yes, something was missing each time I got through. That something was someone but who.
Papers I gave you the other day.
I'll get them right away.
Well, no, wait a minute. I have long since gave you more than my father. Annie, sit down. Annie, I'd like to adopt you.
Adopt me?
Yes or no?
If I can't have my real mother and father, there's no one in the world I'd rather have for a father than you, Mr. Warbucks.
Drake!
Yes, sir?
Call Justice Brandeis and ask him to come over and sign those adoption papers.
Oh, yes, sir.
Tell Mrs. Pugh that there will be a house full of guests. We'll need flour.
Flowers.
Caviar.
Caviar.
Champagne.
Champagne.
Going to be an adoption party. It's going to be a celebration. And you can have anyone in the world you want to come with. Who would you like? Babe Ruth, Johnny Rockefeller, Madame Chiang Kai-shek? She's a lot of fun.
Well, I guess I'd like Miss Kim out here. And Mr. Drake, Cecile, Annette. I guess I'd like everybody here.
Of course. That's who I'd like too. Drake. Tell the staff that they'll be the guests at Annie's adoption party. Tell them to get spiffed up.
Yes.
Grace.
Yes, sir.
Have Cecile put Annie. Oh, why? That's a very nice dress you're wearing.
Thank you, sir.
Have Cecile put Annie in one of her new dresses and have Annette do something with her hair. I don't know, take her upstairs and gussy her up.
Gussy her up.
Gussy her up. Gussy her up.
Annie, Annie, Annie.
Everything's humming now.
Hum, 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 hum. Good times are coming now since you came. Again. Again. Yesterday, love. But that's never.
now, Oliver, Annie, we're ready to begin. The procedure's very simple. According to the laws of the state of New York...
Sir?
What?
Sir?
Excuse us, folks. We don't mean to interrupt. Shirley, look. There she is. There's our girl, our Annie.
Who are you?
Honey, we're your mom and dad.
Ralph Mudge is the name, and this here's the wife, Shirley.
Mr. Mudge, is it? We've seen a great number of people who've claimed
proof.
To be...
I expect you'll be wanting proof of who we are. Here's our driver's license. And here's Annie's birth certificate.
Baby girl, name Anne Elizabeth Mudge. Born to Ralph and Shirley Mudge. October 28th, 1922, New York, New York.
October 28th? That's my birthday.
It was in her notes, sir.
Yes, I know. But I still don't. Please, sir. You gotta believe us. We got in on the Greyhound this afternoon and went down to the orphanage to fetch our Annie. And the lady there said she was up here.
Oh, Annie, all the years I dreamed of holding you in my arms again.
Mr. Mudge, on the night Annie was left at the orphanage...
Oh, here's something you wouldn't know about. But when we left Annie at the orphanage, we left half a silver locket with her. And we kept the other half. So it's one day...
Look, Ralph, she's wearing it.
And here's the part we kept. It fits perfectly.
Oh, thank God, Ralph, she's already.
She is, she is.
I suppose she is.
Well, if you'll be getting Annie's things, we'll be taking her along.
Take her?
No.
Problem? Think we
Mr.
have
Mudge, what about the money?
What money? Well, we ain't got much, but we'll be glad to give you whatever.
You haven't heard that I've offered a $50,000 certified check to anyone who can prove that they are Annie's parents.
No, sir. We don't know nothing about no check.
No, we couldn't take no money for Annie.
On the other hand, Cheryl, remember that pig farm over there in Canada? I mean New Jersey, we came from Canada. With $50,000, we could buy it. We could afford to bring Annie upright in the country. With fresh air, fresh eggs.
Fresh ham?
Fresh ham. Certified, huh? All I gotta do is make it out to myself?
Yes, that's correct. Tomorrow morning.
Tomorrow morning?
Problem?
No, no, sir. It's whatever you prefer. Well, we should be getting back to our hotel now. Goodbye, Annie. Till tomorrow morning, then you'll be spending the rest of your life with us.
Goodbye, Annie, love.
Well, goodbye, all. Pardon me, doll. Merry Christmas.
Season's greetings, one and all.
Well, this is wonderful news.
Yes, wonderful.
Annie has found her parents. Mrs. Greer, champagne.
Yes, sir.
You're lucky, Annie.
Right. I'm lucky. Just think, a pig farm.
We must celebrate, because it's Christmas and we've just heard the most wonderful news in the world. Annie has found her mother and father. A toast. To Annie Mudge.
To Annie Mudge.
Annie! Annie!
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
I seem to have the same effect on everyone.
I've lost her. I've lost Annie.
Sir, that Mr. Mudge, I think I've seen him someplace before. I can't remember when or where, but I have the strangest feeling he's not who he says he is.
Mr. President, Franklin, I need your help.
Of course, Oliver. Whatever I can do for you.
But the thing is, they knew about the locket.
A locket? That's your key.
But nobody knew about the locket except for us. And the FBI, of course.
And Miss Hannigan. And Miss Hannigan!
And Miss Hannigan.
And Miss Hannigan!
Miss Hannigan, sir. And children from the orphanage.
Miss Hannigan, I'm so delighted to meet you.
Same here. And I know you anyways. You're the Oliver Warbucks, right?
Yes. You already know my assistant, Grace Farrell.
Yeah.
And this is the President of the United States.
Sure.
And this is my butler, Drake.
Hi, kids.
Hi, Annie!
Look, kids, there's Christmas presents here for all of us.
Oh, my goodness!
Warbucks, a message from the FBI.
Thank you. Comes the dawn. Now it all fits together.
Annie, come look at this.
Leaping lizards! Who would have guessed?
Show it to the president.
Sir, Mr. and Mrs. Mudge.
Show them in here. Show them in here. Drake. Franklin. Shall I have them call for your car?
No, Oliver. Eleanor can wait.
Won't you please come in, Mr. and Mrs. Mudge?
Good morning.
Good morning.
And Merry Christmas, one and all.
Merry Christmas.
Merry.
Thank you, Drake.
Christmas.
Well, we don't want to be a bother on Christmas and all. We just come to get Annie. A suitcase?
Allow me.
Oh. And the check?
Yes, Mr. Mudge. Here you are, $50,000, certified.
Certified. Pay to the order of Ralph Mudge.
Read it again.
Pay to the order of the jig is up.
Yes, the jig is up. Daniel Francis Hannigan, also known as...
Rooster Hannigan, also known as Ralph Mudge, also known as Danny the Dip.
Bye, Mom. Bye, Dad.
Franklin, I believe that fraud is a federal offense and that your Secret Servicemen have the power to arrest.
Yes, Oliver, indeed they do. Drake, will you turn them over?
Yes, sir.
Deck the halls with boughs of holly, fa la 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 la. Tis the season to be jolly, fa la 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 la.
Hey, so look for Warbucks. And you'll find this woman's their accomplice, fa la 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 la. Arrest her too, please.
Me? I never seen these people till yesterday.
Aw, come off it, Aggie.
Yes, sis. If Lil and me is taking the fall, so is you.
Mr. Warbucks, Oliver, I ain't done nothing to you. I've always been...
The jig is up.
Annie, tell him how good and nice I always was to you.
Gee, I'm sorry, Miss Hannigan. But remember, the one thing you always taught me, never tell a lie.
Rat! I'll let you know a secret. I never liked you. I never liked any of you.
You, your name's a number.
Let me at her!
Annie, we'd like to meet your friends.
Okay, good. I'd like you to meet Miss Grace Farrell.
Hello.
Hi, kids.
And this is Mr. Daddy Warbucks.
Hello.
Hi, kids.
Oh, yeah. And this is the President of the United States.
Hello.
Hi, kids.
Kids, Miss Hannigan is gone for good.
Yay!
That means you won't have to work anymore.
Yay!
Instead, you'll have classrooms and teachers.
Yeah!
Hello. Oh, but listen, kids. No more rocks.
Yes, girls, for you, and perhaps for all of us, this Christmas is the beginning of a wonderful new life. I know the depression's depressing.
The carols are still, the stores are filled.
And windows are minus the dressing.
The children will grin, the Santas are thin. And
I've heard a terrible rumor. But we'll get a new deal for Christmas this year.
The snowflakes are bright and they're falling.
And a lot of sticks, no peppermint sticks.
And all through the land folks are falling.
I'm filled with despair, cause cupboards are bare.
Santa's got brand new assistants. There's nothing to fear there. For Christmas this year.
Bun, 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 bun,
bun, bun, bun, bun, bun, bun, bun, bun, bun, bun, bun, bun, bun, bun, bun, bun, bun, bun, bun, bun, bun, bun, bun, bun, bun, bun, bun, bun, bun, bun, bun, bun, bun, bun, bun, bun, bun, bun, bun, bun, bun, bun, bun, bun, bun, bun, bun, bun, bun, bun, bun, bun, bun, bun, bun, bun, bun, bun, bun, bun, bun, bun, bun, bun, bun, bun, bun, bun, bun, bun, bun, bun, bun, bun, bun, bun, bun, bun, bun, bun, bun, bun, bun, bun, bun, bun, bun, bun, bun, bun, bun, bun, bun, bun, bun, bun, bun, bun, bun, bun, bun, bun, bun, bun, bun, bun, bun, bun, bun, bun, bun, bun, bun, bun, bun, bun, bun, bun, bun, bun, bun, bun, bun, bun, bun, bun, b
want you to join with us in the singing of tomorrow. Please sing with us.